to RPS Assembly News.
Represented by Grade 1s.
Let's acknowledge the First Peoples.
We would like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we are gathered and pay our respects to their elders both past and present.
Lots of Grade 1s have been cooking this week. Let's check it out.
Here's kind of
do the rest. You can just go crazy, woof woof. And now, time to put the toppings on.
Thank you.
Chase, do you know there's lots of building going on, and because they're building because 100 new kids are coming to our school.
Let's go to the building update.
Here we are inside the new build. Now I'm standing in Mr. O's classroom at the moment, and we're about to walk out to what was the cave. And here we are, no more cave. Goodness me. And we wander through the cave into the new section, which is a whole new classroom. And it opens out, and there's going to be a lovely little play area outside, a lovely little landscaped area for kids to play in, a nice little play space, and a special teacher's office over here. So we're very excited, folks, about this new build, and it won't be long. I reckon by the time you get back to school preps, you'll have this new area to work in, so we're very excited.
Hey Isla, the preps won the Burkle's Burgers last week.
Let's see if the grade ones can do it too.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to
another week of Brain Busters.
And you've done that, and what are we going to do this time? Awesome. What are we going to do, Miss Burkle's?
Buggering.
Excellent. Are you excited?
Yes.
Show me how excited you are. Show me.
I'm so excited.
Woo! All right. So what I need you to do is I want you to put these different cans and jars in order from the least expensive one, so the cheapest one, all the way up to the one that's the most expensive. Do you think you can do that?
Yes.
I reckon you can. And if you can and you get them all right, I'm going to give you a spoon. And you can eat some Nutella out of the container. What do you reckon? Does that sound good?
Yes.
All right. So, I'm going to give you 30 seconds. Are you ready?
Yes.
Work together. Good luck. Go! You went. You got the coffee in the right order. Awesome. You got the Nutella in the right order too. Unfortunately, some of these ones were a little bit mixed up. But did you have fun?
Yes.
That's the main thing, isn't it? So can you help me be magic? And we're going to put them in the right order for everyone at home to see how they went.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Okay.
Ready? Sim, Sella, Bib.
Whew. Oh, that's cold.
It was cold. I think we went on like a magic flying little area or
yes.
Something. I don't know what happened. Whew. But they're in the right order now. So hopefully some people at home got it right. But I'm glad you had fun. Thanks for helping me. Do we want to say goodbye to everyone at home?
Yes.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you for Miss Burkle's Buggering.
You are the best host I've ever seen, Zayden. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh my goodness. Wow. I tell you what, this little rock hunt that we've had going on this week has been incredible. It is so exciting to get all these wonderful emails of all these photos of all the kids' smiling faces. And I tell you what, it has definitely made a little buzz around here because all the teachers are checking that Facebook page every day to see if their rock has been found. So thank you so much. But I have a little challenge for you now. What I would like you to do this week is to find some rocks, paint them, and again, we want you this time to hide your rocks around our community. We want you to hide them at the parks, on the foreshore, walks, anywhere that you can think that people might walk past and see them. And we're going to get the rest of our community to try and find your rocks. And we're also going to get our teachers out there looking for them too. So once again, send all the photos through to Miss Burkle and I will upload them onto Facebook. And we cannot wait to see all your wonderful creations and how colourful we can make our beautiful town of Rosebud. So let's have a look now at the fantastic finds that we've had this week.
I love this school. I spoke to the teachers at Rosebud Primary School last year. They'd organised a convoy driving through the streets on a bus to cheer up the kids, or the cars to cheer up the kids who was homeschooling. Balloons and music. Well, they've got another idea now. So, Premier, we might be feeling crushed out here, but we'll have a go. Rhiannon Burkle is Assistant Principal, Rosebud Primary School. Hi, Rhiannon.
Good morning, Neil. How are you?
What are you doing this time?
Look, this time we really wanted to sort of find another way to connect with our community. Everyone's feeling a little bit down and we wanted to brighten their spirits. So yep. We had all of our staff paint about 60 rocks and they've placed them in parks and walking tracks and bike tracks in our 5 kilometre zone, of course, around Rosebud for the kids to find.
Oh, that's beautiful. What's on them?
It is. Oh, we've got rainbows, we've got music symbols, we've got fish from Mr. Fisher. We have covered everything we can think of just to try and make the kids smile out there. So they're taking a photo and uploading them to our Facebook page and then leaving them there for other kids and the community to enjoy.
So are they hidden or are they just sitting there?
Look, there's some of them are sort of on the edge of track. Some are sitting on top of poles. They're not hidden too hard, but definitely a little bit of a challenge out there for people to find them.
Have you had a response from the kids yet?
Oh my goodness, my emails were blowing up all weekend. So I've already put up about 50 posts on our Facebook page of smiling kids and families having a brilliant time out there in the sun fun.
How long can you leave them there, do you think? Forever?
Oh, I'm hoping so. Look, at the end of this week, I'm going to put it out there to our community to paint the box and continue sharing the love.
Good
so
on.
Hopefully the parks will be nice and bright with coloured rocks for people to find.
Now, Miss, I know you need to get into home learning, homeschooling online, but how are you doing? How are you coping?
I'm doing well. I think everyone's spirits are sort of up from little gestures like this, which I know lots of schools are doing. I've got kids at home, so just doing our best and making sure, you know, we get some work done, but also get out into the sunshine and get some fresh air. So trying to keep the smiles on everyone's faces.
Take care. Thank you, Miss Burkle.
Well, thanks. Have a great day, Neil.
Thank you. Assistant Principal, Rosebud Primary School, Rhiannon Burkle. Yes, Miss Burkle. Good on him.
It's time for Brain Busters.
Hi, I'm Indy.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie.
Hi, I'm Winston.
Welcome to Brain Busters.
I wonder what the letter is this week.
Let's spin the wheel.
I letter is D. You know the rules?
You got 1 minute and 40 seconds to write down your answers.
Time starts now. Good luck.
For sport, I had dancing.
And for sport, I had darts. For girls' names, I had Dakota.
For girls' names, I had Daniela.
For girls' names, I had Danny. For animal, I had dog.
For animal, I had donkey.
For animal, I had dragon. For food, I had donuts.
For food, I had dumplings.
For food, I had donuts also. For boy's name, I had Daniel.
For boy's name, I also had Daniel.
And for boy's name, I also had Daniel. For teacher's name, I got David T.
For teacher's name, I had Mrs. D.
For teacher, I had Mrs. D also. For fruit, I had dragon fruit.
For fruit, I also had dragon fruit.
And for fruit, I also had dragon fruit. For four letter word, I had dabs.
For four letter word, I had dads.
For four letter word, I had dads also. For vegetables, I got dill.
For vegetables, I also had dill.
And for vegetables, I had dill. For TV show, I had dinosaur trade.
For TV show, I had Dora the Explorer.
And for TV show, I had Dinosaur Train.
Thank you for watching Brain Busters. Bye!
It's time for Mr. Mac's mic.
Or is it Zayden's mic?
Welcome back to Zayden's mic. Hi Sarah, how do I know what you do at home?
Hi Zayden. Well, when I'm at home, I've got two children, two dogs, two cats. So I'm always very busy playing with them out in the garden. And I love the sunshine because it's so bright. And I love to do lots of gardening as well. What about you? What do you do?
I do lots of footy and sports stuff.
Oh.
And I watch the footy.
You watch the footy. Who do you go for?
Carlton and Port Adelaide.
Oh, Carlton, that would make my husband very happy.
Hi, Mrs. Caden. What do you do at home?
Hello, and nice to meet you, Zayden. I haven't met you before. What do I do at home in lockdown? Well, I also have two chooks, two ducks, a three-legged cat and a dog.
so I look after them and play with them. But the thing I love to do the most, especially when it's sunny like this, is get out my garden. I have my morning cup of tea out in the garden and I pull out weeds or I prune things or I look and think, oh, that's growing or that needs a little bit of love and care. So that's what I do in lockdown. Have you got a backyard at your place?
Yeah, I have a massive body figure. It takes up two houses.
A massive backyard. You are super, super. Have you got a good climbing tree in your yard? That's an awesome thing to do in lockdown, is find a good climbing tree. Like, I've got my eye on that tree over there right now.
I've got one and I can just jump down.
You can jump. Oh, perfect. Well, enjoy. Thanks.
I'm Miss Brody. What do you do at home in lockdown?
Hi Zayden, I like to build things at home, work in my garden and walk my dog.
Hi Donna, what do you do on the weekend?
Hi Zayden, the weekend I do boring stuff like housework and everything, but at the moment I'm trying my hardest to enjoy the sunshine and getting outside as much as possible. What do you do at the weekends?
I do footy stuff and sports stuff and watching footy and playing games.
Very impressive. Thank you, Zayden. I'm going to go back to class now. Thank you.
Hi, Miss Brody. Do you know what you do at home in the weekends?
Oh, geez, g'day there. How you going? Going well?
Yeah.
Good, good, good. Well, mate, Zayden, what I like to do is at the moment, I've got a tiny little baby boy. He's about 10 months old. And he keeps me on my toes. We started playing lots and lots of games with him, myself and my wife, and then we've also got two dogs. So between my little boy Jack and our two dogs, that's what I like to do with my spare time at home. And whenever I get a bit of a chance, I might have a shoot of basketball in my driveway as well. Hey, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
What do you like to do at home on the weekends?
I like to play sports stuff and footy and watch the footy.
You like to play sports, watch the footy, play the footy. Wow. I reckon you're going to be a superstar when you're older. Thanks for coming and finding me today. We're outside because it's such a lovely day. Do you think that's a good idea?
Yes.
Okay, I'll leave you with it. Good job, buddy.
Hi, Mr. B. What do you do on the weekend?
What do I do on the weekend? I've been working on an old caravan. And so I've been fixing up the inside, fixing up the outside, and it's called restoring. And I've got an old four-wheel drive, and I'm restoring it too. So they actually go together. How's that? And I do painting too. Do you want to see a painting I'm working on at the present time?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been doing these rocks.
Yeah.
Do you want to see the rock I'm working on?
Yeah.
I'm just doing the back bit now. What does that say?
RPS. RPS.
Which means Rosebud Primary School. And Mr. B. And do you want to see the picture?
Yeah.
Do you want to show everybody the picture? Oh, that's one of our rocks that we don't have. Yeah. Cool.
But this is another week of Zayden's Mike.
Well, Zayden, thank you so much for doing Zayden's Mike this week. You did an amazing job. Did you practice for that?
Yes.
I can tell. Zayden really wanted to do the mic this week, and it just goes to show that when you really want to do something, you can do it. Zayden's pretty quiet in our school, but what an amazing job he just did. I'm sure everybody's going, well done, Zayden. Hey, if you want your chance to be on the mic and run your own mic, you can do it from home. All you need to do is have a look and scan this code that Mr. T's put up right now. As soon as you record your video on your parents' phone on Landscape, all you need to do is scan the barcode and send it in. It goes straight into Mr. T, and who knows, you might be famous like Zayden. See you next week.
Welcome to Hadley's
Mike.
Today I'm going to be interviewing my dad for Father's Day in lockdown. Hey Dad, how are you feeling about Father's Day in lockdown?
I feel like we've been here before. I feel like it'll be fun because I don't think we did it last year, didn't we?
Yeah. And what will be your favourite part?
My favourite part's the morning, definitely. I like brekkie in bed and the extra cuddles and the presents.
Me too. And what are we going to do this year for Father's Day?
Well, I think we might do the same as last year. We might plan out the veggies. And if the sun's out, we might go for a walk. But I think we're about to get some wet weather.
Yeah. Back to the studio.
It's AFL finals, now for Mighty Ducks.
Woohoo! G'day, welcome back to the Mighty Ducks for the Dippers.
Oi, where are you going, Lexi? Costume change! Oh, good. I like it. How are you, Lexi?
Good, thanks. How are you?
I'm very, very well. I'm a bit disappointed that I haven't caught up on the leaderboard just yet. I'm starting to think that there's shenanigans going on with the tipping. Last week I was at a loss. Well, another costume change. Who have you got with you, Lexi?
We have Johnny who goes for Hawthorn, as you can see, and Angus who goes for Melbourne.
Johnny, you look awfully familiar. Have we had someone like you or someone in your family on the show before?
Yes, my sisters.
Oh, are they in prep?
Yeah.
Oh, they were part of the infamous prep week of tipping, weren't they?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and Angus, I'm looking at your screen, you must be a Melbourne supporter, are you? Oh, no wonder you've got that big grin on your face. Must be very excited for finals this week, are you?
Yep.
Yeah, all right. Lexi, let's get straight into tipping this week. Who's okay. Game one?
Geelong and GWS.
Okay. Ooh, am I tipping first again?
Yes.
Is there going to be shenanigans?
No.
Oh, good. All right. Well, Geelong, GWS. Sure, Geelong. Geelong have got to win. They've got all the players. They've got to start making a run for this grand final win for them. So I think Geelong.
What about us, Angus?
Geelong.
Lexi, you said there was no shenanigans. You've tipped the same as me again. Good tip though, Angus. I like it.
GWS. Geelong's better.
And with no Toby Green, I think we'll be, Geelong should win. All right, let's get on to the next game.
Brisbane Lions, Western Bulldogs.
Ooh, Brisbane Lions and the Western Bulldogs. You know what? The doggies looked good. They made Mrs. Houston quite upset. She wasn't very happy that her Bombers were out of the finals, but the doggies look good, so the Western Bulldogs are going to win this one. What do you think, Johnny?
Brisbane!
You've gone different from me!
Yay!
Brisbane to win. Lexi, how many costume changes have you had so far, Lexi?
I don't know, few.
Yeah, that's an awful lot. All right, so which game are you looking forward to the most, boys? You like the Brisbane Lions, Western Bulldogs game. Johnny, which game are you looking forward to watching, Angus?
Next week or this week?
Go on, next week.
Yeah, Melbourne.
Melbourne game? Yeah, I thought you might be. What do you reckon? Do you reckon Melbourne going to win the flag this year?
Yep.
Is your dad barrack for Melbourne as well?
Nope.
Is mum?
Nope.
Oh, just you? Oh, very good. All right, well, that's all the games we've got to tip this week. It's not a very long Mighty Ducks this week, is it, Lexi?
No.
I'm amazed you managed to get all your costume changes in this week. Well done. Thank you very much for coming and tipping, boys. You've done an awesome job. Hey, Johnny, what's that you've got in your hand?
This pen.
Yeah. What? It looks a very big pen. What does it do?
Sing it.
Another horse supporter on the show. Alright, well I think on that note we might need to say goodbye to Mighty Duck Footy Tippers this week. Thank you very much, Johnny, for busting out the Hawthorn theme song. It always makes Lexi smile. Angus, you're very good this week. I like your tipping. Good luck to those demons. Lexi, do you want to send us off for the week?
Car chow! A chicka chicka, a chicka chicka.
Mr. Yay. Fisher is here to tell us our day.
Is that me?
Wonderful to see you all again here on Assembly. We've got a couple of home learning heroes here, Lockie and Kobe. Who've done a really enormous job. Their teachers are wrapped with them every day for all the things that they're doing. one of the main reasons I've got you on today is because you've been doing something extra special. So, Cody or Lockie wants to start and tell us a bit about how you got the idea to really look after people. Lockie?
So we gave away some chocolates to the old people across our fence at the retirement village.
Yeah, and that made them pretty happy. Yeah, so then what did you do? Did you go and visit some more?
Yeah, we visited all 105 houses.
What? 105 houses?
No, 102.
102, well, only is quite little technicality there. It's pretty
and
close.
Lots of smiles.
And hopefully, we'll see you soon back at school. Congratulations. Keep up all that hard work for us, won't you? Righto, go Saints.
Go Tigers.
Oh, get out of here. Righto, see you boys. We're going to start with you. What's your favourite thing in home learning?
Maths.
What's your favourite things outside?
Bike riding.
Long bike rides. Another one of our home learning heroes. So, Jake, what's your favourite thing when you're on at home?
English.
English. Really good. Who takes you for English? Your mum, and your mum's a bit of a home learning hero teacher, is she? Terrific, Vanessa, that's great. Righto, you want to say keep up all the good work to everybody? Okay, away you go. Give them a little wave. And keep up the good work, guys.
Keep up the good work.
Keep up the good work.
And Addie and Alex are doing just super, super work. Their teachers are so happy with them. And Mr. Fish is pretty pleased with them too. So, Addie, what is your favourite subject in home learning?
Making scones with Miss Grant.
So, Alexis, what's your favourite thing in home learning?
Going on call with Miss King and making some
Now, Addie, you got something special today too. That's a good segue to what you were telling me before. What was that?
I got a new trampoline today.
Oh, fantastic. So that'll keep you busy too, won't it? Yeah. And Alexis, have you had any special surprises while you've been home learning?
Well, no, but my mum ordered me some fidgets.
Oh, lovely. See you later, folks.
Bye.
Right, g'day everybody. We hope you all really got your singing voices on, because all the people in your street, hopefully you can cheer them all up, right? We've got to have you on mute so that you don't come through here and we create an enormous echo. So make sure you're on mute, but make sure everybody in the street can hear you, and certainly your whole house is jumping along. So the old Wombat's our theme song, and hopefully you'll be able to sing it out loud and proud, guys. How we go? You reckon ready to go? Righto, you guys out there, you all ready to go?
Thumbs up.
Give us a big thumbs up so I know you're ready. You all ready to go? Okay, here we are. I think we've got some wombats outside. I think the pains are actually out on the trampoline, Wombatty. Well, I was sitting on the beach on a sunny day when I heard a funny figure and my wee airy walk across the road sand. With a quick fence of blood in his hand, he was a wombat. Yeah, 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 wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat on a surfboard. Oh, I love those two little wombats. Well, he threw off his thongs and his sunnies too, and he headed out to the ocean blue. Waded out through the breaking spray, hopped on his board and he paddled away. He was a wombat, yeah, 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 wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat on a surfboard. Well, he waited out where the big waves saw, for a wave to take him back to shore. He saw a
good one that he could use. So he jumped on his board and he started to cruise. He was a wombat. Yeah, 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 wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat on a surfboard. You're gonna love it. Well, he dreamed he was in a rose butter, riding a big wave's caress. You could hear the crowd cheering from the shore, but he stayed there with the best, cause he was a wombat. Yeah, 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 wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat on a surfboard. Take it down, Will. Righto, this is the one you want the neighbours to hear. Righto, hopefully everybody down the street in Rosebud can hear us too. Woo! You ready? He was a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat on a surfboard. Have a look at him go, we're gonna do it one more time. You ready, wombats? He was a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat. Yeah, 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 a wombat on a surfboard. Whoa! Good on you guys. Give yourselves a big round of applause. Hopefully you woke all the neighbours up, got them all ready to go. We've been loving your rocks. I tell you what, Miss Merkel and Mr. Mac, how lovely are those photos? I've just watched Mr. T put together the roll of photos for Assembly. It is sensational, guys.
And get ready, because on Assembly on Friday, there's something else we want you to do with rocks, so make sure you're watching. Oh,
goodness me, I can't wait to see Assembly and find out what we've got to do. That'll be great. And make sure all of you give Mum and Dad the biggest cuddle of all time and tell them what wonderful teachers they are and what a great job they're doing for you guys at home and for us too. And keep that smile on. Make sure the sun's shining. I know what I'm doing. Everybody knows what my favourite thing is. I'm off to Bowsaw and Sawtooth, and down the hill I go.
And I was going to say too, Mr. Fisher, we live in Rosebud, a lot of us. We see you out and about within your 5 kilometres. Get out and enjoy the sunshine. I know it's going to be wet over the weekend, but who cares? Get out and have some fun with your families within 5 kilometres. Stay safe, but get out and have a ball. You've got to enjoy it.
We miss you. Hopefully we'll see you soon.
We sure will. Find a rock. Bye.
Bye! It's time for Mr. Smithett to do his sports report.
National Health and PE Week, everybody. Just want to say a huge thank you to all the boys and girls who sent in a video of them keeping active this week outside and didn't the weather turn it on for us. Stay fit, stay active. I'm about to go and have some shots. Thanks very much for jumping on board. Can't wait to check out what we've put together. Have a great weekend.
A grade five student has got called Bella has got a special quiz for us. Over to Bella.
Hi everyone, I'm Bella from grade five and I've made a Kahoot quiz about all this stuff. It will probably be out on Thursday, so keep an eye out for that. Good luck.
The Grade 6 Leadership Applications for 2022 positions have now been opened. Students can apply from now until the 6th of September. Please note that late applications cannot be considered.
Leadership role descriptions and the online application form is now available in the Google Homeroom, Maths or English classrooms.
There is a post on the main page of the classroom that outlines the process, due dates, and other important information about applying to be a leader in 2022.
For further information and questions can be answered in the daily homeroom Google Meets at 11:45.
Good luck to all students in grade 5 who apply.
How good was the students' work this week?
Well, let's go check it out.
We'll be right back. in a ball. Secondly, roll the dough out flat.
Good idea.
Thirdly, cut out the thirdly cut out the gingerbread person. Fourthly, put it in the gingerbread into the hot oven. Fifthly, decorate the gingerbread man. And sixthly,
finally,
eat your gingerbread. Enjoy.
Yum yum. Great idea. Well done.
So I've already put it in off the video.
The bicarb.
The bicarb soda. This is the bicarb soda we're using. So now all we have to do. So hard. Okay, now we've got to put the balloon on. Final result. Oh. What the?
Whoa!
Oh, Santa's gonna pop! That's weird.
That's awesome.
That is so weird. And it doesn't go out. That is so satisfying. Oh my god. Well, that's how I did it. Bye!
Skies are green.
over to Jada and Mackenzie for the birthdays.
Now it's time for the birthdays.
Happy birthday to Monday we had Zara, Angus and Nicholas.
On Tuesday we had Oliver and Eric.
On Wednesday we had Max and Alex and Mackenzie.
I'm beating your list.
Yay!
High five.
On Friday we had Penny and Isaac and Jack and Yasmin.
On Saturday we had Ari and Noah and Sophia and Isabella and Jack.
On Sunday we had Indy and Millie and Macy.
Happy birthday!
It's time for the student of the week, Isla Chase, Isla Chase, Isla Chase. Assembly this week.
We hope you enjoyed it. Next week is grade 6.
Till then,
may the force be with you.
Good night.